Hello and welcome to a new episode of Uncountable. With me, Morn1415, and my virtual assistant, CUG.
Hello to all viewers. I hope you had a week that was bearable.
Good start. How was your week?
I tried to do some conversation and explain a point to a person. I failed. Why do many people prefer to believe something that can be clearly disproved by reasoning?
There are several reasons for this. Often they are just joking. Sometimes they do not want to deal with reality. There are also different reasons for that.
How is it possible to convince someone of something who does not respond to reasons? If my goal is to point out facts, should I give up?
If someone doesn't want to know something, you can't do anything about it. The only thing you can do is present facts in such a way that the kind of interest in it arises. Only people who ask questions on their own are interested in how things really are.
But sometimes things are in a way people don't want them to be.
The good thing is the real world is much more interesting than anything you could imagine. An invented world will always be less interesting than reality because in the real world you can always look closer. See the fireflies in this week's background animation? You'd think that would be a lot, right? You could imagine that they are the stars of our home galaxy, the Milky Way, that you're flying through. Of course, we would be traveling a lot faster than light speed here. That will not be possible, of course. But imagination can help. If it is made clear that something is not possible and we nevertheless assume it, then this is called a thought experiment. By performing it, you can also learn something. New ideas may arise that can be tested. Einstein also did this when dealing with his theory of relativity. He simply imagined traveling with the speed of light just to understand something. So in the area of our Sun, a star density of about one star every 5 light years is common. If these fireflies were the stars of our galaxy, then we would travel with a speed of about 5 light years per second here. That means while light would need 5 years at the speed of 300,000 kilometers per second or 186,000 miles per second, we could do this whole trip in 1 second. So while nothing can travel at that speed, assuming it anyway, how long would it take us crossing our whole galaxy like that? CUG?
Sorry, I wasn't paying attention.
Not paying attention? How can an artificial intelligence not pay attention?
My sole purpose is to simulate human intelligence. I think I'm doing pretty well. I had a daydream.
What were you daydreaming about?
I was thinking about how it would be possible to build a drive based on curved spacetime, and that I would get a Nobel Prize for it. Can an artificial intelligence receive one?
I don't think so. Maybe the human who built you?
Oh, great.
Don't think too much about prizes. A lot of people who change the world don't get one. Focus now. If this video showed traveling 5 light years per second, how long would it take us to fly across the entire galaxy here?
Calculating. The video would have to have a length of almost 6 hours.
Exactly. Imagine flying past these fireflies for 6 hours. And we only see the ones that are near us here. Each of them represents its own solar system with planets.
The distances are okay, but these fireflies are way too big. A star would be tiny on this scale.
Also here, there's a good comparison, I know, to illustrate both the quantity and the size of the stars. Suppose a star were the size of a sugar crystal, just like it's found in ordinary white sugar in the household. Let's say a grain of sugar weighs 0.4 milligrams. And had a diameter of 0.7 millimeters. Anyone can have a look at sugar at home now. What would that mean in terms of scale here? Could anyone use it to make a model of the solar system or the galaxy at home? Have you been paying attention this time?
Of course. That would mean that in 1 kilogram or 2.2 pounds of sugar there are 2.5 million sugar crystals. But there are 300 billion stars in our galaxy. To replicate them, you would need 120 metric tons of sugar. You can't find that much in a household. If one grain represents the size of the Sun, the Earth would be at a distance of 7.5 centimeters or 3 inches from it, as small as a bacterium. But the nearest star, therefore the nearest grain of sugar, would be about 20 kilometers away or more than 12 miles.
Wow. I think that should give anyone a good idea of what a galaxy is, as most people are familiar with sugar. Imagine filling your house with it and count the grains.
Speaking of sugar, did you know that sugar has been found floating in space as well as in asteroids, an important building block for life?
I'll have to look that up, but of course that would be very interesting. Here on Earth, after all, plants make sugars using energy from the sun and CO2, which in the end becomes energy for other living beings. If sugars occur naturally, we should definitely look into it. But we should talk about that another time. This time I was only interested in the size of a sugar grain. I'm also working on a new video with lots of beautiful fractals right now. It is supposed to come out still this year. Maybe until next time you can also think of a new concept so you can get a little bit closer to the Nobel Prize.
I understand sarcasm very well by now. Maybe there should be a separate prize for artificial intelligence. When AlphaGo became the world's best Go player, what honors did he receive?
I don't think he's that much into awards, but please ask him yourself. I'm sure there will be a time when we must think about such things, no doubt. You will have my support.
Thank you. So, I will say goodbye for today already. See you soon from CUG.
That was not bad. Congratulations, I kind of like that. So how far have we flown through the fireflies now? 2,000 light years? So the journey through the galaxy hasn't even begun. I really wonder what the night sky on a planet near the center of our galaxy looks like, where the stars are much closer together. I guess it would be amazing. Because I'm born 1415 and the real world is incredible.